The Shantungosaurus was a huge dinosaur that used to tower over the old landscapes of China in the late Cretaceous. It was a force to be reckoned with because of how big it was, and it also had a lot of ways to protect itself from possible predators. How did this huge hadrosaur get here? How did it grow so quickly? And what made it such a strong opponent? To learn about the Shantungosaurus' rise and fall, we must first go back to its old home. Imagine yourself in a land with lush plants and many different kinds of animals, where powerful rivers flowed through large floodplains and valleys. This is where the Shantungosaurus lived and grew, along with many other dinosaurs, like the horned ceratops and the armored ankylosaurs. It was in charge of the Shandong Peninsula, a beautiful and dangerous place. Paleontologists had never seen hadrosaur like the Shantungosaurus before. It was the biggest dinosaur, even bigger in length and weight than the well-known Tyrannosaurus rex. It was a powerful figure in its environment, as it was 15 meters long and could weigh up to 16 tons. Even though it was huge, the Shantungosaurus was not just a giant that moved slowly. Its strong back legs let it move surprisingly fast when it needed to, giving it a way to get away from possible enemies. It wasn't alone, either. These dinosaurs were social and traveled in groups, which made them safer. Even though the Shantungosaurus had strong defenses, it wasn't too aggressive when it came to what it ate. It was an omnivore at heart, and it had an amazing set of teeth with more than 1,500 teeth made to chew tough plant matter. Its beak cuts through plants like scissors, making it a true master of its plant-based lifestyle. Even though it had a lot going for it, the Shantungosaurus had to deal with problems. The Gigantiranus, a big theropod and top hunter, could still be dangerous to young animals or animals that live alone. But the full-grown Shantungosaurus was a tough opponent, even for the powerful Gigantiranus. It was big, strong, and lived in groups. As time went on, the world the Shantungosaurus lived in changed all the time. Changes in the climate and the appearance of new enemies may have helped it grow into a giant. But in a strange turn of events, these same changes might have killed it off in the end. The late Cretaceous was a time of a lot of change, and as the Earth moved into a new era, fossils of the Shantungosaurus stopped being found. Even though we may never know for sure why the Shantungosaurus died out, it left behind a great heritage. As the biggest dinosaur we know of that wasn't a sauropod, it shows how different and beautiful life was back then. So, the next time you look up at the stars, try to picture these huge animals roaming the Earth and making their mark on history. The Shantungosaurus, a real giant among giants, is no longer around, but rocks and fossils that tell its story keep its memory alive. So, thanks for watching, and until next time, keep learning about the amazing things that happened in the past.